So are you aware of the quick actions inside of Photoshop? Not the actions, but the quick actions. One click, you can do a number of things. So let's jump in and look at it right now. And by the way, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. In Photoshop, we go up under Help, and then choose either Photoshop Help or Hands-on Tutorials. This opens up the Discover panel. If we hit the back button, we can see quick actions. And if you look, there's a number of different actions that we can do in a single click. You can go by category or just look at them all. We're gonna go through three of what I think are the best ones. We're gonna blur the background last bit. The blur background actually kind of sucks, but I'm gonna show you how to get around that. All right, so let's just start with something basic. We wanna make the background black and white in this photo. All we do is just click Make Background Black and White. And look at that, it immediately makes the background black and white. What it does is it creates a new layer in Photoshop and we can make adjustments. So if you wanted to change the mask, you could click here, or we could refine the black and white by simply clicking there and see how we can change the way the black and white goes. So this gives you just a little bit more control than you would get from some actions. All right, let's do a second one. One of the things people want to know how to do very often, duotone effect. Let's just click, it creates a duotone just like that. And if you don't like the gradient map that's being used, simple, just click, it brings up the gradient map. You can choose different ones. Each gradient's gonna give a slightly or radically different result. All right, let's look at the blur background. Something that people wanna do all the time. Here's the problem. If I apply the blur background as it stands, it blurs the background, but look, we get this halo all the way around. Because when it looks at that edge, it blurs the edge and then it picks up a little bit of the subject. So let me show you a better way of doing this, still using the quick actions. Let's go with Select Background Quick Action. Notice that that loads in the background. Perfect. Let's hit Control J to put that on a new layer. And that would be Command J on a Mac. Perfect. Let's load that selection. Control or Command click on the selection. And now that loads that selection there, but we've got a hole cut out now, which shows the area underneath. This will constrain it. And now we can apply a blur. Now let's choose blur, Gaussian blur. And notice now we can blur the background as much as we want. And it's not creating that halo around the edge. Why Adobe didn't write it that way, I have no idea. So just a quick tutorial this week to make you aware of these quick actions. Did you guys know they were even there in Photoshop? Let me know in the comments underneath if you even knew that these quick actions existed. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider hitting that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my useful tutorials. And by the way, guys, if you like this, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up, the like button on YouTube. It helps us with the algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.